In my last video, we talked about why doctors might treat themselves differently. Well, let's crank it up a notch. This may come as a shock. Very few doctors would ever choose to have their penis enlarged. I know it's a provocative comparison, but let me ask you, are drug dealers their own best customers? Usually not. They know about the risks and benefits of their products. Now, let me make this clear. Doctors are not drug dealers. Medicine is not for making people sick. But when we talk about cosmetic procedures on normal-sized penises, we enter an ethical gray zone, a place where patients turn into customers and doctors start acting like merchants. In addition to that, look at it this way. If penis enlargement surgery actually worked the way men imagine it does, don't you think doctors would be the first to sign up? I mean, come on, we're doctors, we have access, we have information, we can afford it. If this were the golden ticket, we not only had the longest waiting list in history, but guess what? We don't. And that should make you pause. Every single day, millions of men are bombarded with ads promising a bigger, better, stronger penis. Pills, pumps, fillers, traction, surgery. The message is simple. Size equals worth. But here's what no one talks about. The people who know the most about these procedures, the surgeons, the urologists, the sexual medicine specialists, almost never choose them for themselves. That's not arrogance. That's knowledge. And that gap between what's marketed and what's real, that's the truth I want to unpack. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. I know you guys watch a lot of AI slop channels run by fake doctors with fake titles. Whenever you watch that, just remember who's their daddy. It's UroChannel. Okay, here's something every one of you can relate to. Let's talk facts first. The classic surgical technique, suspensory ligament release, doesn't make the erect penis longer. It makes the flaccid penis appear longer by dropping the angle. Typical visible gain, 1, maybe 2 centimeters. That's about 1 inch. But the price? Loss of stability, a shift in erection angle, scarring and retraction at worst, and a long rehab that often ends with disappointment. Then there are fillers, hyaluronic acid, autologous fat, synthetic gels. They can make the penis look thicker. But even here, it's not Mother Nature's work, it's Brother Doc Johnson's. And it may come with a price. That's for the next video. You might want to stick around, subscribe, and you won't miss it. And traction devices? They are proven to work. Real gain, up to 1 inch. But only if you use them for months, hours per day. For some men, 1 inch means the world. Doctors would smile sarcastically at that. Now, here's where it gets really interesting. For most men, the penis is not just an organ. It's a symbol, a cultural lightning rod, power, manhood, value, comparison, shame, all mixed together. But when you're a urologist, when you've seen thousands of penises of every shape, size, curve, scar, color, angle, something shifts. The penis stops being a symbol. When you've heard the word penis 10 times before breakfast already, it becomes anatomy, it becomes work. It becomes a place where biology is louder than fantasy. And that shift changes everything. What others inflate with meaning, we deflate with facts. Facts can hurt because they reveal the truth. The majority of men seeking penile enlargement have normal penises, not small, not deformed, normal. A 2015 study by Veal et al. In BJU International found that more than 85% of men who sought lengthening surgery were well within the normal range, around 12 to 15 centimeters erect. Zero had true micropenis. What they suffered from was what we now call penile dysmorphic disorder. Not a defect in the body, but a distortion in the mirror. The more porn, locker room talk, and Instagram comparisons, the bigger the distortion. And surgery doesn't fix a story that lives in your head. So why don't doctors get these procedures? Because We see the outcomes. We know the complication rates. We know about the minimal gain in comparison to the costs. And perhaps most importantly, we're not living inside the same cultural story. When the penis stops being a symbol, the pressure to fix it evaporates. If these procedures really delivered what they promise, hospitals would have staff discounts. But they don't, because deep down everyone in the field knows the return of interest is lousy. And you know what's lousy as well? A therapist telling the patient the truth. Because this is psychology 101, the patient can only accept what he developed by himself. But I don't have time, this is only a short video, therefore, your worth is not measured in inches. And no, that's not a fluffy Hallmark line, that's the lived reality of men who've gone down this path and come back with scars, debt, and disappointment. There are better ways to work with your body and less risky ones. If doctors don't do these procedures for themselves, maybe, just maybe, it's time to ask why. Not because you should feel ashamed, but because you deserve the truth. If you found this useful, share, like, and subscribe. If you still want the Penuma, then watch this video and decide for yourself. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.